In this lesson, we're going to learn how to make a wrapper inside our website, which is basically a way for us to group content inside our pages. So before we start coding anything, I would like to show you guys just a couple of examples to make sure you guys understand exactly what a wrapper does inside our website. So if I were to go inside my browser here and take a look at YouTube inside my channel page, you guys can see that all the content inside this page here below the banner follows a certain line on the left and the right side. So if we were to scroll down, you guys can see that all the content does not go past this line that I'm drawing with my cursor here. And the same goes for the right side of the website. Now, if we were to take a look at my website, which I'm creating at the moment, you guys can see that my wrapper inside my front page is not really that narrow. So all the content essentially goes almost to the left and right side, but not quite. But if you were to go inside one of my subpages inside the website, such as the HTML and CSS tutorial series, you guys can see that the wrapper is much more narrow and follows a certain line inside the page here. So I group my content inside a container that has a fixed width, but not a fixed height. So the height is infinite. Okay, so if we were to go back inside our code, you guys can see that in the previous episode, we learned how to make a navigation. And what I would like to do inside my pages here is to just create a piece of text that says which page we're inside of. So if we were to go below the nav tag, I'm going to go ahead and create a h1 tag. And I'm going to go ahead and call this one, because I'm inside the front page, front page. If we were to copy the h1 tag, go to contact after saving this page, of course. Going to do the same thing, paste it below the nav tag and change this one to contact. I'm going to go ahead and save it, go to portfolio, do the same thing here, call it portfolio, save it, go to about and do it inside this last page here. There we go. So now that we have this, we can go ahead and see what we have inside our website. If I were to refresh, you guys can see that right now the text goes all the way to the left side of the screen. And the navigation up here actually does have some spacing, but that's because inside our style sheet in the previous episode, we went ahead and gave the navigation a margin to the left side that was set to 60 pixels. So if we were to change this one to 0 pixels, go back inside the website, you guys can see that now the navigation is touching the left side. Okay, so what I want to do now is I want to create this wrapper here just to make sure that all the content inside the website stays within the same line. So I'm going to go ahead and go inside my code, inside my front page, just to do it in one place. And what I'm going to do here is I'm going to take all the content that I want to go within the wrapper, and I'm going to go ahead and wrap this content inside a div tag. So I'm going to say we have a div tag, and again, we have the shortcut where we can click tab after writing the name of the actual tag. And as you guys can see, we get a pair of div tags. I'm going to go ahead and make sure the closing tag is after the content that I want to be within the wrapper. So I'm going to go ahead and close it after the h1 tag. And I'm just going to shift all the content out just once by clicking tab to make sure we have some sort of organized system inside our code. And I'm going to go ahead and give this div a class, and I want to name the class wrapper. Now, we could have more than just one type of wrapper if I want this wrapper to be a certain width, but if I want a wrapper inside my navigation to be a different width, of course, we can name them differently, such as wrapper-main or wrapper-navigation or nav. You can go ahead and do that, but for now, let's just go ahead and use one wrapper. So I'm going to go ahead and save what we have here and go inside the style sheet. And at the very top, right after we have our body tag code, I'm going to go ahead and create the code for the wrapper. So I'm going to say we have a class called wrapper, curly brackets. And inside the curly brackets, I need to give two values. I need to give a margin, which is going to be the thing that actually centers or, you know, pushes the wrapper where it needs to be inside the page. So if I want the wrapper to be completely centered inside the website, I need to set it to 0 pixels from top and bottom and auto from left and right. Now, the auto styling basically goes in and says, okay, how much space do we have on the left and the right side? And then it takes that spacing and divides it in two, and then it puts it on each side of the wrappers, so it automatically gets centered inside the website. So the second value we need to have here is a width. So I need to decide how much space the content should actually have inside the wrapper. And when it comes to the spacing that we need to type in, a normal thing is around 1,000. So we're gonna go ahead and say we have a width set to 1,000 pixels, like so. Now, if we were to go ahead and save this and go inside our browser, refresh, you guys can see that all the content has been pushed to the center, and the navigation bar, the one with the white background, has also been centered, meaning that, as you guys can see, it only goes to the wrapper width. Now, we need to fix this because I would like the bar to go all the way from left to right, and the content inside the navigation should be inside the wrapper like the content is inside the actual page. So if I were to go back inside my index page, and then take the wrapper, the beginning tag, copy it, then delete it. I'm gonna go ahead and put it right after the nav tag instead, because I want the content inside the nav tag to be centered. So I'm just gonna shift out all the content in here. And again, we also need to include the closing tag right after our menu here. So I'm just gonna include it here as well. And now we need to move back the navigation inside the code. And I do that by holding down shift and clicking tab, just so we have, again, an organized code inside our file here. Now, I would also like to have the content inside the page that is not the navigation to be inside the wrapper, because right now, if I were to save it, you guys can see that only the navigation has been centered inside the wrapper. So I'm gonna go ahead and copy the wrapper again, and I'm going to paste it right after the navigation tag, and I'm also gonna close the div tag right after the content inside our website, like so. So now, if we were to go inside my browser, refresh, you guys can see we have the wrapper inside our website. Now, just to show you guys, because it can be a bit tough to see if there's no background, if I were to give the wrapper a background color set to something like red, so we can actually see what's going on, refresh the browser, you guys can see that the wrapper goes, you know, where the content starts, till just about over here, which is 1,000 pixels. Now, if I want the content to not be centered, but instead almost touching the left side with just a small amount of spacing, because some websites don't always have, you know, all the content centered. So if I were to go back inside my style sheet and go to my wrapper here, I can go inside the margin. And instead of saying auto, I consider we have 0 pixels from the top. I have an automatic wrapper from the right side. And then on the bottom, we also want to have 0 pixels. And on the left side, I would like to have about 60 pixels. So when we count, you know, margins and paddings and that sort of thing, we always do top, right, bottom, left. So if I were to refresh the website, you guys can see that all the content goes on the left side here. Okay, so this is basically how we create a wrapper inside our website. And this is something we need to use when we want to create websites in the future. So when we do actually get to the project that I want to create with you guys in a couple of episodes from now, we will be using a wrapper to create a full website. Okay, so I hope you guys enjoyed. I'll see you guys next time.